Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue Eat Streak here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance series. Yesterday's video has not crossed 5,000 likes yet, but Thursday's video definitely did. Thank you all very much for making that one happen. We're now only 15 days away from the like streak goal. Let's see how much better it can get. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by, once again, Chris1226Hero. How the thread was, can't waste them keys. Sharp key, actually being a good item? Nah. Sharp key. Being bad on purpose so Sinvicta doesn't waste his keys. Ah, I like that. That's a good mentality to think, Sharp Key, because that was not good. Although I know that there's like a lot of people who really support Sharp Key, but I was not impressed. I know it can open doors and stuff, but I'd rather just use a key. See, today's going to be Delta November 3, Papa 4, Tango Foxtrot 0. We've got good damage, decent tears rate, and we also have large zit. And a very good chest to start off with. Also have Yum Heart, of course. That is a decent starting item. Of course, it's Maggie's starting item as well. But the problem is that we have no Red Heart. So it's going to be a little bit suboptimal. It's not going to be traditionally a good idea to depend on something that can't actually give you HP for, like, you know, life-saving techniques and stuff. Don't think I didn't see that Shmoove there, game. I saw that. We all did. Right, what do you think about that Shmoove? Think about that. You want to walk through rocks? I can shoot through rocks, bro. Depression. You know, it's like, I've seen depression absolutely crush certain bosses. Just waste them. But there's also times where, like, depression just doesn't do anything. I mean, it's a familiar and it doesn't count towards conjoin or anything like that. So there's certainly no reason to not pick it up. It's just, you know, supplementary damage, as we like to call it. There comes that supplementary damage term that I like to use all the time. But yeah, it's just kind of like, you know, depression's not great. In before hundreds of comments that say, oh, Sinvicta, quotes Sinvicta, depression's not great. Yes, that is not great in any stretch of imagination, unless if the trites jump into the cloud and trigger the crack the sky effect. So I've been having a lot of people come over to the Twitch channel after my recommendation of checking out Isaac Madness Week. We had some very hilariously bad and good runs happen, and it's been a pure delight. If you're watching this here on Saturday, then definitely don't miss out. We still got, you know, two more days left of Isaac Madden Week. I'm going to be doing it Saturday and Sunday this weekend. So come check it out, twitch.tv/Invicta. Moshpit's been making some legendarily hilarious and awesome runs. Except for one of them. Sorry about that. Been having storms in the area, so I'm trying to figure out if I need to actually be like, do I have enough time? I was checking the weather. Do I have enough time to get this Isaac run done before this thunderstorm hits? I think the answer is yes. I'm almost positive, unless if this one starts taking like forever. We get a strength card here, which is going to be very useful if we decide to go for the devil deal. As we get the temporary HP from the strength card, we can use that to, as like, sort of like a, you know, just temporary currency for the deal with the devil. Hopefully it's worth it. The problem is that even if we take a deal with the devil and we get, with assuming that we don't use the strength card accidentally, it's going to take everything but, it's going to take everything but one soul heart. So, It just comes down to, you know, is gambling on the deal with the devil and sacrificing the chance to get an angel deal worth it or not? And lately, the answer has been yes, because the angel deals have not been good at all. In fact, they've been non-existent. We've been getting runs consistently, only getting, you know, maybe three angel rooms tops for the entire run. And that's, you know, the odds of you getting something like an absolute banger in one of those angel deal items or angel deal rooms are less than great. You know, even if you don't factor in Sinvicta luck, like, you still have to get, you know, one of the very few good offensive items that you can out of the angel deals. Whereas if you go for devil deals these days, especially with everyone getting more and more acclimated to repentance and getting just used to everything, which is what acclimated means, you can really find yourself thriving off of devil deals again. So all that to say, if we get a chance to get a good angel deal, that'd be cool, but I'm not gonna go for it. Not on a run. The only way that I would go for an angel deal on this run in particular is if we ended up getting a good tiers upgrade here. But all signs are pointing to probably not, but it is Baby Plum, and I mean, all the bosses are going to be randomized. Well, not all the bosses. Most of the boss loot are going to be randomized anyway. The most important thing that we need to remember right now is to not take any damage at all. Because, again, okay, cool. Baby Plum, just the ruiner of dreams and hopes. Because, again, if we do take a devil deal, we have to remember that it's going to take all of our HP. Now, Latchkey coming out is a big down play, but unfortunately, I have a cult or Ocular Rift or a Blood Oath, Dark Arts. Dark Arts can be good. I'm not a huge fan of either one of those. Ocular Rift can be good for crowd control. I just don't think that... I don't think it's worth losing all that HP for, even with the strength card. I'd rather wait. Bide my time. Now, Stitches, on the other hand... Now, Stitches allows you to get places that you normally wouldn't be able to get to without taking damage. And on top of that, it does massive amounts of damage. Does massive amounts of damage to stuff that it hits. I swore that we could get through the curse room. I'm pretty sure you can get through the curse room without taking damage. I don't know why we're stuttering like that. It's weird. Anyway. But yeah, Stitches is going to allow us to just straight up unload on things. And of course, us getting more options is very, very helpful as well. Gives us the extra item in the item rooms, which again, more variety, more items, you know, better ingredients, better pizza. But the main factor and the reason why Stitches was so lauded at the beginning of Repentance, and this is something that I did not know until, you know, thanks to the help of the Mosh Pit, was just about the damage. I had no idea that Stitches dealt damage, and man, oh man, is it massive. Well, I mean, we don't have a key. Got a weather update. It looks like the storm is should miss this area. Right there, you saw a huge spike in damage. And wait till you see what Stitches does against bosses. It's amazing. It really is quite good. Stitches deals contact damage. I didn't know that. Man, Stitches, you're just surprising me all the time, you know? Yeah, well, this is bad. Wouldn't let me go. All right, whatever. Just shoot the bombs. Just get out of here. There we go. All right. Okay. Hey, how are you? Yeah, go get him, Stitches. Yeah, I had no idea that Stitches dealt contact damage. I mean, obviously, I knew it dealt, like, you know, nothing personnel kid damage, but, like, you know, not just like you can use it like Blue Baby's only friend. I wonder how much contact damage that actually is. It seems to be, like, it's pretty decent. But yeah, man, Stitch is just good. It's a very, very strong item. The one thing I like about it, too, is if you combine it with 9-volt, ooh, baby, then you are actually, like, becoming one with, like, the... One with the blade. Random soul heart here. We might go. Might have a secret room here, possibly. I'd have to. We have four bombs. We can check. I didn't think so. It was kind of iffy on that. More likely it's like, you know, a little bit further into the level here. Man, and I didn't even think about the depression combo as well. Being able, oh, yeah, that was not a good idea, Zinvicta. I didn't think about the depression combo as well. Being able to just combo it, like with the contact damage and the beams from depression. But that's me. What you just saw right there is a classic example of me tunnel visioning on one objective, which was like, hey, like, look at this. I can snipe these hosts, and without realizing that, yeah, you're also putting yourself in direct danger of the other host because you're going to be point blank, you moron. Yeah, those are the kind of stuff that's the kind of thoughts that go through my mind only after I've done something stupid. Very important to just stop and think. I mean, Flatstone, I'm still just not really a big fan of. I used to think that Flatstone was good. And it is good for like a range extender and stuff, but in terms of like practicality for just, you know, normal use, I don't think that Flatstone is all that's cracked up to be. Skibbacak is very good though. Okay, well, I'm glad we're getting these super, super duper good shops here. There we go. We don't have to waste a bomb on destroying the keeper, at least thanks to Stitches. Finding the secret room is kind of a noodle scratcher. Yeah, it's got to be north of here. I say that's the only real danger of Stitches, is just putting yourself in harm's way. Yeah, you have to kind of think like fourth dimensionally in a way of where you're going to be ending up. Gonna be super lazy here. Not sorry. Okay. Amino. I don't know why the second hit didn't cause any damage. So if you let Bumbo, if you just let him take enough money, he just leaves. And honestly, that makes him like a lot more tolerable, just because, like, you know, it's Bumbino. I didn't want to take that much damage, of course, and lose. I mean, we didn't lose that much money, but we have the counterfeit penny. We'll be all right. You know, counterfeit penny, of course, is going to increase our the monetary value of coins by one every now and then. Sometimes every coin. I think it might actually be every coin in Repentance now. Yeah, let's just get ourselves out of harm's way here. Another nice thing about Stitches is that you basically can just sneak up on your enemies without them even realizing that like you're targeting them, which is kind of nice. So you don't have to trigger like, you know, the red hosts or like, you know, anything that has like, you know, homing or anything like that. Statues included, you know. Stitches just throwing up a dominating performance so far. We'll say that it is a little bit it's a little bit jarring whenever like you switch to the Stitches mentality, but then like, you know, it's like, oh yeah, I'm about to teleport. We need to go in the complete opposite direction of where I would usually go, because normally I would know how we get here. This time around, it's like, oh no, I don't know how we got here. We just teleported. All of a sudden, we just woke up and we're in the library of Runa. By the way, thank you to those of you who've been supporting that series. Been doing okay. My goal on that one is to get 5,000 likes. 1,000, I mean, 5,000 would be great, but 1,000 likes per episode of Library Runa. And the Mosh Pit members who have been watching that series have been trying to make, you know, a big push for that to happen. So I thank everyone for doing that. It helps out a lot. It's like the scariest thing when you hit the space bar, are ready to use stitches, and then you just don't go anywhere because you're accidentally over a gap. All right, so Little Monstro and Giant Cell. I mean, I like Little Monstro. I think Little Monstro does deal a pretty impressive amount of damage, especially just for like a familiar, just a regular familiar. It's a reliable source of extra damage. And we're already doing, you know, kind of okay damage with, I mean, we're doing good damage with stitches, obviously, but in terms of like our raw stats, like we haven't improved yet. And that's okay. That's okay, because we're smart and we're clever and we're handsome. We smell good and we know exactly how to come up with alternative means of damage. But getting some extra help from our damage stats would be kind of nice. We're going to combo Depression here with Little Monstro and just kite and shoot, kite and shoot, kite and shoot. Very good. Also, we don't have a lot of HP either. This is quickly becoming a very rather apparent problem. I don't mean a parent problem like a, you know, like I'm your parent and you give me a problem. I mean, like, it's an apparent, readily apparent problem that we are not doing too hot on HP. Russian doing a good job on Peep, though. Champion Peep at that. Excuse me, Peep, you're dead. Thank you. That is a 73% deal with the devil or angel. Down the drain. Burp, 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 burp. And Curse of the XL. All right. Yeah, buddy. Looking good, Isaac. Looking good. It could not have been a worse scenario for that to have worked out the way it did. So this will be a record. The only way that this won't be a record low amount of special rooms is if we get another XL on the next floor, which is possible at this point, unless we find Black Candle. So that's fun. That's really, really bad, because we effectively have, in six floors, we've gotten, no. Yeah, six floors, we've gotten one devil deal. Without taking damage, without, you know, without actually like squandering it. That is insane. That's not supposed to happen. The absolute max is supposed to be five. I almost don't even want to open this. Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, think on your toes when Stitch is in play, man. See, you can't miss like that. It's a great shot by Little Monstro, though. I am liking this Depression combo with Stitches, this teleport. It's really, really surprisingly working out well. Just dropping the cloud right on top of them is seemingly working very well. Very, very well. Maybe. You can go through there. Wow. It's so weird how we were sticking on the first floor like that. Okay. Cardio coin actually pretty darn good here with the counterfeit penny. We could take extension cord, which would give us another very good amount of damage. Actually, extension cord would give us a more than very good. That would give us an excellent source of alternate damage there. What? There must have been creep on the ground or something that hit us. So we don't have to bomb the charge beggar because it's a 100% deal with the devil. Excuse me? Thank you. And so you see the beams of lightning there across all of the familiars. We're going to have to stop relying on stitches, though, because it's getting to the point now where we don't have the HP to be just dipping in and out of combat like this. Although that is pretty good damage right there. Not even just using stitches, but like just the contact damage and extension cords doing numbers. This has like been a secondary damage like fiesta here. I'm kind of loving it. Suboptimal to be picking up these coins without having, oh my goodness, well. Suboptimal picking up these coins without having the counterfeit penny, but I'm not going to go back to pick up the counterfeit penny after every single coin that drops, especially since we probably will get a greed fight here. The ultimate slap in the face. Okay, this is the worst case scenarios besides dying here. We get a devil deal, and it's Krampus. And then we go to the next floor, and it's an XL floor that has no devil deal. As in, like, we don't get one. That's the cream of the crop worst possible case scenario. Is that we get a Krampus fight here, we get a greed fight in the store, and there's no devil deal on the next floor. Basically. Now, pause is interesting. Although, I don't think pause helps us without having an orbital. What I was thinking about there was like, you know, oh, wouldn't it be cool if we actually had like, if we just use the extension cord as our primary source of DPS. But if we have pause, then we don't have stitches, which is the main reason why we can stretch the beam across the entire screen. So this is pretty neat. Pretty neat. Emperor card. Okay. Well, at least that helps out a little bit. I mean, I'm not abandoning our boy Stitches now. We need to slow our roll with the usage. We don't have the HP to be cutting in, and you know, there's nothing personnelling these kids. A very odd place for the Tinted Skull. Wow, depression. Good lord. Those rooms now contain devil deals. Yeah, we only have one. I mean, we still haven't been to one treasure room. And I'm already anticipating. Well, no, because we're using the extension cord. And plus, even if it had like an amazing devil deal in there, it would have to be the tip top best devil deal ever in order for me to go down to one HP on this run with these stats. It would have to be Brimstone or Mega, and even then Mega's kind of a risky maneuver, or Mom's Knife. Yeah. I was hoping that was gonna cancel that animation out. Man, I'm not even like shooting anymore. Okay, Nun's Habit's actually pretty darn interesting for this build because if we get hit, we can just teleport away. I like that. King Baby is death for this build. We don't have to destroy the Keeper because 100% chance. Now what is interesting is that we could take Devil's Crown and then get our almost guaranteed angel deal. But knowing my luck, we'll probably get a devil deal anyway. So, yeah. That's a room that is not going to be there. All right. Oh, we've already been to both item rooms. Never mind. Calculated risk. Take meat. Good damage up. And we're not going to be able to use stitches against mom. Not without taking huge, huge damage. However, I will use the beam and Jacob's ladder and a combination of the two. We have to hope that Tinted Rock up there is a bunch of soul hearts. Did get an angel deal. Pascal's Candle is... it's an item that just improves your run. It doesn't have any downsides to it. But it's not what we're looking for right now. We were hoping for some overwhelming damage or HP or something. But it's not the worst thing that could have shown up. It could have been like, you know, Trinity Shield or something like that. Pascal's Candle or Pascal's Candle, however you want to pronounce it. It's going to give you a tears up every time you destroy... every time you clear a room without taking damage. And then upon taking damage, the candle resets. And those are the kind of items that I wish we had more of in Repentance. Sort of like the skill based, like, you know, you get what you put in. You know, if you do a good job, or if you've got a good run going, it's only going to multiply the benefits of an already good run. Or if you're good enough at the game, it can reward you for being a better player on a run that is going almost nowhere. Now the tiers up that you get, obviously, like I just got done saying, they're not permanent, but with a strong enough build, they become semi-permanent in a way. What is this? Hangman, sure. Man. Stood about the only place in this room that we could have been hit by that shot. Not thrilled about losing our soul heart there. Again, we're skating by the skin of our teeth right now in terms of HP. I would love to be using stitches a little bit more, but we just can't. That's just a Tinted Rock in here. Super secret room is most likely to the north of here. Jacob's Ladder is just upping the pain on the game right now. Cannot overstate how important Jacob's Ladder is at keeping us safe right now. On top of like all the other like kind of like sort of piercing AoE damage that we've got going on, Jacob's Ladder is just real, real, real nice. Big help. This is one of those rooms that is considered to be, I don't feel like doing it. It's usually not worth the trouble, unless you're just stomping the game. It'll be Conquest, which is not going to get us any sort of upgrade, unfortunately. Okay, that's a neat trick. Okay, and there goes our angel deal. Who knew that Conquest would be such a barn burner? Right. tonight, and we will head on down. And Curse the Blind, which doesn't really matter, but at this point, I mean, I'm going to take anything. Surprising lack of HP items, which is usually a common complaint of ours, but this time around, it's been like, wow. I mean, we've got good, like, the thing is, like, we've got good items, but, like, in terms of, like, being able to protect what we've got, for HP-wise anyway, and accumulating that HP has been the real issue here. And most of that is a combination of me tunnel visioning on using stitches and also the game just trying really, really hard right now. We don't push buttons. The game pushes my buttons, but we don't push in-game buttons. The reason why taking damage is not great here is because, again, we lose that bonus that we get from the candle, which is instrumental in keeping us alive due to Jacob's ladder. But I mean, we've been seeing a surprising lack of, like, tinted rocks, a surprising lack of soul hearts in general. That XL floor really, really stung. And one of our main sources of HP are shops, and losing a shop out to the XL is pretty bad. I mean, that would have been horrible if it was a greed fight. Luckily, it wasn't, but. No, we didn't get much out of that shop anyway. Look at the stretch range on extension cord. Jacob's ladder, of course, because there's water in here, or at least there's liquid. It's going to stretch out a little bit more in terms of the range and the chaining ability. Oh, that was cool. Oh. Invisible mob spawned underneath us. That one was neat. And then that right there is an example of the game trying really, really hard today. We are not going to let the game win when it tries hard. We're not going to let the game win. I've beaten more difficult runs with way worse than this game. We gotta deal with the devil. Yeah, and we can't take any of that. All right. This is where the importance of holding on to the Emperor card is paramount. Now, of course, that being said, staying alive throughout all of this is the most important part. But assuming that we don't die in the cathedral, which we won't, getting to the chest and then just skipping straight to Blue Baby is what saves Streaks. That's where Streaks are saved. And I'm really hoping that we get a little bit of help. Otherwise, it's going to make the Isaac fight very stressful. I'm also not hoping for a bunch of dead ends, which so far is our MO here. A difficult run, but I have faith. What gives me faith is Jacob's ladder. Okay. Good. So there's the north and west side of the map. Let's just go check out the south side of the map here and take a gander. Possibility of it being the right way to go. Oh, that was neat. Trying to kill them all in one fell swoop. Turn to one fell poop. No tinted rocks, huh? No tinted rocks at all. Mm-mm. You lose the tears up, unfortunately. Golden bomb, we need to be looking for the super secret room on every wall that we can access. We're gonna probably end up doing a full clear no matter what, because this is our last opportunity to get blue fires reliably anyway. But it's always a risk because, you know, you're prolonging your exposure to possibly taking lethal damage here. That is not lethal damage. Okay, so we have two there. And there's a tinted rock here. That's run winning right there. Now, if you're curious as to why I'm not picking up the soul hearts yet, it's because I want to save them for Isaac. And I don't want to waste them before that fight. Now, the possibility, of course, is there that we may die before picking those up, when that would make this look like a total donkey move. But again, if I'm playing with the mentality that I know that if I hadn't found those soul hearts in the first place, we'd still be in the same predicament. That gives you the mindset of we just cannot by any means get hit. So it is your responsibility to not get hit. And I know that sounds easier said than done, but that's kind of like the headspace that like I'm in right now. All right. So in this scenario, we did get rewarded for the gamble paid off hugely. Now, that being said, let's not lose it against Isaac. But we have a very strong anti-Isaac build here with depression and the wombo combo of stitches and extension cord. I'm just gonna park him right there, then we're just gonna fire. We're just gonna go buck wild with Jacob's ladder and hold on to this tears bonus as long as possible. Not using Little Monstro because I'm not concentrating on looking at the charge bar for Little Monstro. I'm more concentrated on the beams. Apologies for radio silence here. Imperative that we do not take damage against Isaac. Perfect. Perfection. The Curse of the Maze is the only thing that could put a turd in the punch bowl here with the Emperor card. But it didn't. All right, we have one more job to do. We get Bot Fly's help. Again, the same thing happens here against Blue Baby, except to a much easier degree. Not because of Bot Fly, but just because Blue Baby's just easier than Isaac. So we are going to get the dub here. Very, very strategy-oriented, and not even like on an item level strategy. This was more of just a thinking out loud, we got to play better, strategery episode. So, and it was honestly like it was nice to get challenged here. It wasn't an overly bad run. The game just was, you know, getting stingy with the HP. We took some bad damage, and we were forced to just play better. And you know, every now and then you're gonna have to test yourself, and this is one of those tests that you're going to win or you're going to lose. And this time around, we came through. So shout out to Stitches, man. Stitches and the electrical cord for sure get the MVP here. And of course, Jacob's Ladder is the best supporting cast there. But without Stitches' help and the extension cord, which is a combo I never would have thought I would have even been talking about, that is pretty darn incredible. So thank you for watching, everyone. Very fun run. Go check out that seed if you want to test yourself. Let me know how far you get. Did you beat it? Did you do better than I did? Did you get better? Did you get different items? Did you go a different path? Let me know in the comments down below. Hope you had a great start to your Saturday, everyone. As always, thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing, and I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Cole Rhodes, Together Forever Dan Astley, Ty Kirk, Alex Akam, and Yabez Halligan. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.